We are excellent.
We are brilliant.
We are fashion.
We are creative.
We are royalty.
We are powerful.
We are art.
We are successful. We are strong.
We are beautiful.
We celebrate Black empowerment.
Welcome to Shoma, and I'm from Mozambique. For those of you who don't know, Mozambique is a southern part of Africa. So I moved to Canada in 2006 to go to a dance school. So pretty much dancing is all I do. And one thing that I truly believe is if you can walk, you can dance.
But my favorite part of the Black Junior so far was when the dance instructor came and taught some dance moves. It was really fun to get to like learn a new version of dance and try it. And yeah.
Pretty much it's been 10 years in this beautiful country, and I'm very thrilled and happy to be a part of this beautiful country. And one of the things that I really, really like about that is the fact that I come from Mozambique, and with my dancing skills, and I have the opportunity to work with a lot of people. And the experience, for example, that I had tonight with some of the amazing students here, and it was amazing, you know. They taught me how to become, they always teach me how to become a better teacher, because as a teacher, my goal is to become a better student, because there's a lot of give and take that comes from my side to their side and vice versa. So yeah, it's a treat to be a part of that, and I'm very happy that I was invited to be here today, especially after a long day of dancing, as I finished work today and I came running here. But I knew that I was coming here with a smile on my face, because I will be sharing some of my stuff with people that are willing to take chances to learn. And for me to come here with zero information about the kind of person I'll be dealing with, it was a challenge for me, but it all came down together. It was one of the most amazing, amazing times.
Hi, my name is Vanea. I'm 14 years old. I'm from Scarborough, but my friends and family come to this program. And I just came here, and even though I don't live in this area, they allowed me to join in all their activities and games that they play, and I believe that it's a really good program because they let me know more about my culture and my background and where I came from.
Hi, my name is Tristan. I am a 19-year-old certified personal trainer, and I developed my brand Fit with Tris to hopefully inspire a generation to genuinely love and care for their bodies. So that goes for female and male who are both athletes, not non-athletes, who want to live a healthy lifestyle. It's been great being here with Living Black Genius. I developed my brand in grade 12, and a lot of these kids are approaching that age or already at that age.
I think the exercise session was good. It gave us a lot of tips and stuff, training tips for like athletes and stuff. For me, since I'm a basketball player and a football player, it gave me a lot of tips, a lot of new exercises I could do to help me get better.
My name is Echo Namako. I'm a visual artist. I use Lego predominantly in my practice. And today we were working with the Building Beyond workshop, which focuses on Afrofuturism and descendancy, so that youth can really envision and create their future descendants 1,000 years in the future using Lego to depict how they'll be represented in the distant future. And it was great.
There's a crown over here.
Okay, so she's royalty then, yeah?
And the hair is all different colors. There's gray, there's blue, there's purple. There's a little black over here. There's yellow over here.
Hi, my name is Saima, and I work here at Ray with Rathburn Area Youth and Living Black Genius. And since my time here, I've been really excited to see the range of art and mediums and mentors that Living Black Genius has brought in, from fashion designers to authors to screen printers to building Lego. Lego. So sometimes working with youth, it can be a little hard to get engaged, but I think that the energy and the excitement and the activities that Living Lectures brings in allows our youth to just be exposed to so much and to learn new concepts like Afrofuturism and to learn about people's struggles and their journeys and how they got there. And it's been really exciting too.
Like right now, in 10 years from now, where all you end up, right, you'd be very surprised. It's just choices. A friend of mine is on tour right now with Drake. She also works for OVO, right? But I also knew Drake when Drake was just on, right? And sitting with him in Yorkdale, like maybe, I was like 24, so like 9 years.
Hi, my name is Ayanto, and I'm 13 years old, and I really liked how the dance instructor, Chris, came in and worked with us.
My name is Nayola, I'm 13 years old right now. The most thing I liked about this Living by Genius program was how some of the helpers helped me with my homework. I mean, got really good marks on it. The trips and like the program, like the games that we did, like Colonizer, and they were like really interesting and fun. And like, I wish the students would go on more trips, but I really liked it, what they planned for us.
Good afternoon. Thank you guys for being here. Yes, thank you. This is a 10-year dream.
I'll just tell you a little bit about my life growing up. I was never an academic. Like, I didn't take school serious. It was until probably about grade 12 when I actually started to take school serious. I was actually labeled as being dyslexic, so I actually saw words and letters backwards. So school hasn't really been something that at a young age I took serious. I gravitated to sports. I played basketball, I played soccer. And I did that because school has always been hard for me. I was labeled as being dyslexic. I was in special ed classes. I was actually held back a grade. They don't do that anymore, but at the time I actually failed grade 1. So that really rocked my confidence and had me second guessing myself all the time. And people need to be more concerned with their mental health as well as their education, because school is extremely important. You might not think it is, but I'm telling you, you're not going to get anywhere without education. Future story. Have you seen stories like that? Have you heard stories like that?
I have.
Yeah.
I've had friends, and I had close friends who put basketball such a like a high level as on a pedestal,
mm-hmm.
and just seeing it all come down because they weren't able to more so have a plan B.
Mm-hmm.
So just kind of seeing it all crash down is very eye opening for mm-hmm. me. Especially because I put basketball as a pedestal myself,
mm-hmm.
and I haven't really thought about a plan.
Mm-hmm.
So I could very well relate to what Future Story and also the people around me.
That's great. So it seems that Future Story has it's resonated with you, and it's also made you think outside of the box. And I think what's really important is people having a plan B. I think in the media, and a lot of successful people say that you only supposed to have one, right. Have plan A, you know? And I'm a person who does multiple things, and I think it's important for the next generation to realize that to be successful, you have to do multiple things.
Any questions about the printing process? This is where the magic also happens, because if I go and I touch it up and all that stuff, I could get fingerprints in my good copy. It's not a big deal if that's what you like. That could be also another one of your artistic touches that you put onto your piece. That's completely up to you because you're the artist.
My name is Janisha, I'm 16 years old, and this program showed me new opportunities. It turned me into a leader. It made me more creative. It gave me a new perspective on Black people.
Oh, you guys to print? Yeah.
actually Alexis McFarlane, and I just did a workshop. I think I'm labeled a little black genius, which is really, it's really cute. It's an honor. The workshop was really good. The students were really interesting. Everyone had their own personalities and own things to bring. And what I really liked about this group is you could tell they were focused and they were learning, they were picking up on things. And the questions made me like really put things into perspective with my own business. So it was great to see that like kind of give and take, teacher, student, teacher kind of relationship in the workshop. I always love that.
Hi, my name is Ira Odura. I am 20 years old and I'm here to talk about how Living Black Genius was able to help me just expand and just to connect with some wonderful people within this program. So just a couple of months prior, I was introduced to a young lady named Ashley, and she is the creative director and also the founder of Omi Woods. And she was doing just a little brief presentation about her brand and what and how she came to be doing this brand. And right then and there, I was just like, you know what, I gotta connect with her. Me and Ashley were able to exchange contact information and beyond outside of the program, but was able to do a little mentorship, and where I was able to help her with and assisting in marketing strategies or just and just providing my knowledge of what I knew on the industry. And she was able to give me that exact same.
I'm here at Rathburn Living Black Geniuses program, and honestly, I had an amazing time. It's refreshing, at the same time, kind of, I don't know the word, but to see that these guys are literally exactly how I was. You know, refreshing because it allows me to have real insight on what's going on with these guys, and you know, I could talk their language a little bit and talk their lingo and be able to relate to them truly. I mean, we live in a time where this is the first ever in the history of the world where a generation is raising their kids on hip hop and certain things like that. So I'm just kind of recognizing that in the position that I'm at, being a millennial, you know, being the age that I am and having a daughter, it allows me to relate to these guys that are like adolescents, 13 to 16. And you know, it makes me feel good. It makes me feel good to know that I can relate, but it's bittersweet because I almost wish they weren't like how I was.
I came to Ray today to talk to the youth about my lifestyle, how I grew up, where I grew up, and one of the main topics that we touched on today was shoes and being able to buy shoes, and at the same time, the effects of having all types of footwear in your closet but not being able to drive a car or have a license. A lot of the youth had a lot to say about the famous kicks that they have or the things that they've been able to achieve, but I gave them insight as to the things that I had when I was a kid, or sorry, as a youth, and the fact that I actually had to sell my shoes to get myself back up again. I had all types of boxing shoes in my closet where at the end of the day, it made no sense. And later on in life, it just so happens that, you know, finished college, finished school, and I got all those shoes back.
What you need, from what you want. Come on. You understand? And if you're not doing that, you're just gonna be stuck with literally what you want. And you're just gonna stay in that position for life.
The Shaffer's trip was pretty amazing. I like the sound effects on the stage and the whole act. And I like how after the show we got to sit on the stage and ask the actors a question. The bus ride was lit. It was just lit. At the back of the bus, it was funny. And we saw some stuff out the window, which was kind of like not normal, but overall,
was lit. Don't look. Yeah. Hey.
Show's good. Thank you.
It's actually hot. Bang, bang, I shot you down. Bang.
Oh, we didn't just have a Black History Month day. We had a Black Future Day. And empowering youth such as me and a lot out there to make us see what's out there in the future.
Yeah,
When we had the party, and we got to do all the stations, like the DJ station and the off station. We had kind of like a photo booth. I liked Living Black Genius because it made me feel beautiful.
Okay, one more time. You got this. Don't worry. One more time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mine, go.
I do it. Okay, on your. Oh, God.
The winner, let's see the winner.
You already know, eating breakfast.
Here, hold it in time.
Gotta bring bread. Gotta bring bread for the fam, you know?
This is the time, what's the time? This is the time.
Break bread, gotta break bread for the fam. Break bread, fam. Show them how it do, fam. Break bread.
Who came in second?
Who came in second? Unfortunately.
All about my brother.
Real Paul.
Who you are personally. One thing I would say is that one thing that really changed for me was when I was in grade 9 and I became a volunteer and I joined a program similar to this. One thing that you guys don't realize that these programs are doing is when you get into, you know, higher stages of your life and things of that sort, these programs actually help you because you're knowing how to talk to people, you're knowing how to network, you guys are talking together every single week. There's a lot of life skills you guys need.
My name is Dennis. People call me Brother Denden. I am working and co-leading with Amanda Nichols and Natasha Adiana Morris, the Peace of Mind Festival. I've done this program called Living Black Genius that's partnership with Ray. Ray is Rathburn Area Youth, and we are here right now, and I would love to have your support, hear your feedback, and if you want to get involved and know more about this, please visit peaceofmindfestival.com.
What?